Hello, this is Drawing 101, and today we're going to learn how to draw Zara Aura. To start, we're going to do the legs. We're going to start in the middle of the paper, and we're just going to do kind of a curve like that. And we're going to do, it's going to curve back up into here. Just like that. We don't want to do one continuous arc, so we're going to leave a little bit of space right there. So this is going to be the thigh. Okay, and then right here. We're going to do some spikes where his legs comes out. We're going to tufts of fur. Alright. And then right here, where the leg's gonna come out. Just gonna have two practically parallel lines. Like that. We have the paw down here. So we're just going to do two curves. The outside of the paw. And we're going to do two more curves for the toes. Okay. And we have the claws. Okay, I can just do some curves like that for the bottom. Alright. Then he has this zigzag pattern on his leg. So you have two come up and they come down. Kind of looks like an M. Do some parallel lines. like that. Okay, and then that's one leg. So the thigh comes into another room. Like that. Okay, and then the leg goes up into the torso. There's gonna be some fur right there. That kind of quits right there. About right here. There's a line right there. This torso starts. We have three tufts of fur, just a couple triangles like this. Smaller one right there. This comes up here. That comes up. And then like that, to show where the... So the torso is. And right here. It goes like that. It'll line like that. Now we'll go up into its chest and the fur up there. Okay. And to do that, we want to do very shallow V shape like this, and it kind of staggers down, comes back up again, and goes like that again until it runs into there. It comes up. It comes back in. Right here. That's quite the same thing. But okay. That's all we're going to do now because the rest is where his face is. Now we're going to do his arm over here on this side. It's right here. It comes out of his body. Kind of curves, gets thin in the middle, and spreads back out. And then we do kind of a curve. Like that, and then it hits into his paw. Right, so his paw. Put it right there. Comes down up into about right there. should have run into there. And that curves up. Out. Okay, and this goes into... the claws and paws. So we can round right there. Right here we have a line. And curves down. That curves. See, it kind of see. And then I draw the claw in. Alright. There we go. And we can draw from there. Makes it easier. And then this claw. Claws are quite thin. Like that, and then we can have this circle right here. For the claw. And I can shade this underside in. Like that. Okay. And then Now I can start to work on the head. Okay, right here they have a kind of like whiskers, but not exactly. Anyway, back right here comes in that. Three points progressively getting smaller. Looks like that, and then it comes down into the snout. Alright. Sorry. But I'm not gonna draw a snout quite yet. I'm gonna do the ear right now. So what we have that kind of curves out. You have a slight S. It curves like that. Curves in. Like that. Alright, now I'm going to do the snout. So it curves down like this. It curves back up. And it's near the mouth. Curves like that. Okay, that curves up. Here, so just the mouth, just two waves and a tooth. Just curves up like that. And then right into the ear. Look about right there. And then starting right here, there is a blue kind of thing on her head. And that curves back in. Little highlight right there. Okay, and then the last little tuft of fur comes out to complete the hen. Just like that. Makes a little bit of S right there. And curve straight down. In. Okay. And then there's just a little triangle nose. Right there. Sorry. Sorry about that. Right here is where the eye is. Just draw a line like that. Okay, so we do a semicircle like that. Okay, and then we draw the iris like that. And we can do like a little highlight. And do the pupil. Just another oval. Okay, and little design right here. Like that. Okay. And white, she has a lightning bolt shaped whisker. Comes out right here. Comes up. Curve back in. Curve back out. Like that. Boom. There's one on this side. That. Okay. And then a little bit more of a design right here. Like that. And then we're going to do this leg and arm. So with the I'm going to zoom on the face just really quick. Pause the video now. Yeah, catch up. All right. Okay, now for the arm. Right here. And curve. And right there we have a curve. And if you come down to about right there. Okay, let me do call that. Okay, now we do another one, but do another one like that. Comes up. Okay, we curve back. Okay, now come back up here. Do two things like that. Okay, and then choose like this lightning bolt kind of pattern. Sorry about that. Alright. And so then it just goes. Yeah, like that. And that, and then. That. Okay, again, kind of a M-like pattern right there. Alright, and then right here. Maybe the other leg. Oh, forgot we need to draw the claw. Okay, like that. Okay, then the other leg. Okay, just goes into the arm. I have the little puffing out part over here. Like that. Alright, now I'm just gonna there, and we're going to start the other foot. So it comes out like this. And that goes down into its foot. Okay, I can draw a claw. All right, and then last one. And that's that foot. And then we just have the tail thing left, so it's gonna come out right here. It's gonna be like that right there. I forgot to do the zigzag. It's gonna be another zigzag on his leg. Like that. All right. Then we do the tail thing. I don't know what it is. And then it comes out like this. Like a lightning bolt on the end. Just do a couple ins and outs. And then he has some patterns on his chest. Just like that. Alright. Another. Alright, and I'm just going to darken my lines. And that is how you draw a Zeraora. Thank you for watching.